Could you describe how those attacks work? A lot of people have heard of them, but they don't really know how they work.
Sure. They're called denial of service attacks, and generally the way they work is that thousands upon thousands of computers sitting in people's offices or homes have been taken over, usually by viruses or sometimes by Trojans specifically aimed at them. But they're viruses that began spreading in a big way in 2003 or so. And they sort of round up all these computers and put them under the control of men, or usually men, called bot herders. And they herd these bots, or which is short for robots. Those computers are then directed, in this case, to attack a given website, ping it with meaningless traffic until the site is overwhelmed and it crashes and nobody can reach it at all. The same group of robotic computers can be used to send spam, phishing attacks, or to steal financial information from the owners. And frequently, usually the owners have no idea that their computers have been compromised at all.
This seems to be the kind of thing that can either be done by a spotty teenager in his bedroom or by an organized gang of criminals.
Right. And it's become increasingly more the latter. And even if it starts out with the 17-year-old, and even if the 17-year-old is the one that organized it, frequently he will come into contact with more sinister, more organized, more traditional criminal figures. That's generally the way the ecosystem has worked. There are different people who have different roles. Somebody might just be a virus writer. Somebody else might organize rental of time on somebody's botnet. So I don't need a botnet to issue a denial of service attack against a competitor. I can hire somebody who borrows time on those machines and pays for it.
Where does your information come from? How did you get in contact with Barrett Lyon, for example?
Well, I first met Barrett Lyon in 2004 when I was working for the Los Angeles Times. I was covering cybersecurity there. And what had happened the previous summer was that viruses had changed from being an annoyance that might shut down your email, your company's email or something like that, to something that was much more commercial. It seemed like these viruses were written to amass these bots, and that they would be used for spam and other things. And that seemed like it was an important change, the professionalization of crime on the internet. But it was hard to write about. And then I heard about these extortion attacks where people, these gangsters, were emailing websites and saying, if you don't pay us $50,000 or $40,000, by Western Union to Latvia or somewhere else, we'll shut down your website. And that was very simple. That's something that anyone can understand, that, all right, organized crime is really involved here. And so I called around to the first websites that were getting hit by these, and they tended to be gambling sites for a number of reasons. And they told me about Barrett Lyon, and then I interviewed Barrett and found out what he'd done.
And you mentioned Latvia as a place where the money has to be wired to. Where else do these criminals come from the information that you have?
Well, a great number of them are in Russia. There are also plenty in the Ukraine. Generally, the former Soviet bloc has quite a large proportion, for a number of reasons, is quite a large proportion of these criminals.
And what are the reasons that a lot of them are based in that kind of area of the world?
One is that the math and computer education, the technical education, is often quite good. And then there are, secondly, I'd say that there's a limited number of traditional professional career opportunities. There's not that much demand for employment. And then finally, there is not only often a tolerance for corruption, but specifically a tolerance for crimes against people in other countries. For years, it wasn't even against the law in a place like Ukraine to attack computers in the United States, for example.
The whole idea of networks of Russian gangsters is a bit 1990s, though, isn't it?
What is? It's unclear how deeply the new gangsters are tied into the old ones. I think they are tied quite deeply, because even if they didn't start out that way, if they started out as a hacking circle, sooner or later they're going to need a roof. They're going to need somebody to negotiate for them in the event that the police stumble on their work. And as you've read some of the stories I follow in the book, they obviously brushed up against very serious criminals, ones that could organize death threats, million-dollar bribes, and not worry about the law at all. And those are not the sorts of people that are just sort of garden variety new, you know, computer hoods, I don't think. I think this is very serious organized crime.
Is this the future of the protection racket?
Well, it turns out, to me, the protection racket is just part of it. Spam was probably the easiest thing to do with these robot networks of computers. And then denial of service attacks are pretty simple technologically after that. But one of the things that happens in the book is that the bad guys that Barrett tracks move what they're doing from the denial of service attacks to identity theft, which is the way a lot of these gangs have gone. It's easier to make much more money sucking information out of PCs that includes banking passwords and the like. Then, of course, it turns out later that denial of service attacks came back into vogue to attack countries and political dissidents, Estonia and Georgia and others.